the question is, how do you make your home safe for your child? Number one, get rid of every sugared beverage in the house. There is no such thing as a good sugared beverage, period. And that includes fruit juice. So you say, wait a second, doesn't fruit juice have vitamin C? Take a pill. There's enough vitamin C in all the other foods. You do not need the vitamin C in fruit juice. Number two, we need to keep the insulin down. Insulin's the thing that's driving the weight gain. Insulin's the thing that ultimately impacts on leptin's ability to signal. The way to do that is fiber. If you eat your carbohydrate with fiber, you will lessen the insulin response. Your insulin won't go up as high because your blood sugar won't go up as high. How do you do that? You look at the side of the package and where it says dietary fiber. If it's a solid, you want to look at dietary fiber. You want 3 grams of fiber or greater. Next, wait 20 minutes for second portions. Kid comes to you and says, I'm hungry. You give him a plate of food. Kid eats the whole plate of food, says, I'm still hungry. You look at the kid and say, how can you be hungry? You just ate a whole plate of food. But the kid is. No one wants to be a bad parent, so you give the kid more. What went wrong there? Very simple. There's a hunger hormone in your stomach. It's called ghrelin. When your stomach is empty, ghrelin goes up, goes to your brain, tells your brain, you're hungry. You eat. Ghrelin goes down. So that should be the end, right? Wrong. The reduction of ghrelin ends up reducing hunger, but it does not induce satiety. Hunger and satiety are two different concepts. Satiety comes at the end of the intestine. So you put the food in the stomach, the food has to traverse 22 feet of intestine, food moves through the intestine through movement of the muscles of the intestine called peristalsis, gets to the end of the intestine where cells that are specific at the end of the intestine release a hormone called peptide YY, which circulates in the bloodstream, goes to your brain, and tells your hypothalamus, the area which controls eating, that you've had enough. That's it. Meal's over. It takes 22 feet of intestine to get that satiety signal. That takes time. So, the third rule, wait 20 minutes for second portions. Let the food work. A way you can move that along, so it's not a whole 20 minutes, maybe 18 or 17, eat your food with fiber, because fiber makes the food get through the intestine faster, so you can get the satiety signal sooner. And you can save all of those second portion extra calories. And then number four, the hard one, the killer, the definite problem, buy your screen time with activity. Buy your TV time, your Facebook time, your video game time, your texting time with activity. If you're outside for a half hour, you can have a half hour of TV. If you're riding your bike for an hour, you can have an hour of video games, etc. The problem is that parents are using the TV as the babysitter, and they don't want to give that up. The exercise has to be consistent and sustained. It does not have to be large, but it has to be consistent and sustained, and that is not part of the American diet plan.